Hello, everybody. How are y'all? I hope everybody's having a wonderful evening. Today, I am bringing you another Disney movie, but wait, you're gonna love it. It is Frozen, and I know all the kids still love Frozen. I know Frozen 2 dropped most recently on Disney Plus, I guess due to all the mess that's keeping us at home. So I wanted to bring you some tips and strategies and things to use with that movie. So kind of the way I'm thinking is when I give you these ideas, you kind of use them throughout the day or even throughout the week, however, you know, you want to do it. And then at the end of the night or end of the week, you watch the movie to kind of bring it all together. That's kind of how I'm thinking. I wish that I kind of let you guys in on that when I started this series, but I really didn't think I was going to keep up with it. So, that is what I'm thinking. So the first idea I have for you for the movie Frozen, these ideas could go with Frozen 1 or Frozen 2. It really doesn't matter. You could even kind of make a huge idea, a huge week deal out of this and have Frozen 1 and 2 as some of the movies that you watch. I know there's also a Lego short movie on, I believe it's Disney Plus, that has Frozen characters in it as well. I mean, it's the only one that's not Lego Star Wars. So, we talked about Legos last video, so tonight it's all about Frozen and letting it go, because I kind of feel like that's some of the things that we need to do right now. That might be some of the best advice, is just let it go. So, what you could do is you could actually start out with a fun snack, which I'm going to say go with cold stuff. So, ice cream, popsicles, that kind of stuff. Even maybe even some really cold Jell-O. Things that are cold would be a really cute snack for this one. If you want to get really crazy, you could make sugar cookies and make them in the shape of snowflakes. That would be something fun. You'd have to go dig those out from Christmas, but that would be something fun to do and let the kids decorate them. Because you know me, I am all about cooking and doing fun things in the kitchen with the kids, so that might be something good for you guys to do as like a snack or kind of however you would like to use it. Obviously, I'm not advocating having ice cream for lunch, but I'm not gonna lie. There are some days here recently where that might have been the choice that I should have went with instead of my healthy choice that I had. So, and you could even branch off of ice cream and make hot fudge sundaes, banana splits, kind of whatever you have around the house. Don't go out to the stores and buy anything extra, because good grief, you're not going to find it out there. So, but have fun with it. So that's your snack idea there. Another thing you can do that would be more the gross motor way is just play the song on Spotify, Alexa, whatever your music streaming station is. Play. Oh, there's my Alexa. Wait a minute, Alexa. We'll wait later. What you can do is just play the songs from the movies and let the kids get up and dance. If it's rainy outside, if it's cold where you are, going outside is not an option. If it is an option, take your music outside and let the kids just play and dance in the fresh air while they sing that song at the top of their lungs. And then you don't have to worry about it killing your eardrums if you're inside. So that's my gross motor activity, is just getting out and dancing. That just, I don't know, there's something about it that just makes you feel so much better once you've done it. Plus, it'll get your endorphins going if you're an adult, and it'll kind of bring us out of the funk that we're probably all in, because we're having to stay at home, or we're quarantined at home, or we're self-distancing and we're self-isolating, those kinds of things. Okay, now let's get to a little bit of the science part that might be really fun for kids. Freeze some small toys in water and turn it into, make sure it freezes until it's ice. And then allow the kids to, number one, pretend that they are paleontologists and they're digging out all the fun stuff so they can take, you know, spoons or whatever and hack away at it. That'll give them something to do. You could also have some ice and have maybe put different things in the ice. It's kind of up to you on this one, and see which ones float more. So maybe if you have a matchbox car and a little plastic dinosaur in frozen ice, and you put them in water, see which one floats, if they both float, if one sinks a little further, that kind of stuff. That could be a fun science experiment for that one. You could also make snow. I know there's tons of ideas on Pinterest. So all you'd have to do is get on there, and that could be another science experiment, making snow. Plus, you're also getting in some fine motor stuff because the kids are having to work those fingers to mix everything together. And then you're also kind of getting in a craft activity as well. So that's a fun thing to do. So far we've touched on food or snacks, which was the ice cream, the popsicles, making snowflake cookies. You could also make your own ice cream if you've got rock salt and stuff like that laying around. I don't have that kind of stuff laying around, so we ain't making any ice cream at our house. We're going to go buy it. Then we've got our gross motor activity, which is basically just playing the music and letting the kids dance to their heart's desire. If they can go outside, let them sing and get it all out. And then our kind of science, crafts, it's kind of all mixed in there together. The hands-on stuff is freeze things in ice and let the kids dig them out. You could also make snow. Like I said, there's tons of ideas on Pinterest. This would also be a fun time to talk about the concept of cold, especially if you have little ones at home. You can talk about hot and cold. This would be a really fun time to kind of introduce those concepts with them and go, ooh, too hot, or ooh, too cold. Things like that. Those would all be really fun things to do. Another thing that you could do, which would kind of go along the lines of fine motor, is get out some white construction paper and just let the kids use scissors and practice their cutting skills if they're little. If they're older, then this is still just a fun craft for them to do where everybody's sitting together and having fun with it. But let them make snowflakes out of the white paper. If you've got some glitter, sprinkle some glitter on there. I have glitter glue. So you could always just kind of squirt that on there and then rub it around and have glitter on there that way. But have fun with it. Then hang it up somewhere. If you have a room, maybe you kind of set the stage for watching the movie and you have snowflakes hanging everywhere. Another cool thing that you could do that would be kind of more along, I guess maybe you could do it along the lines of maybe reading. I kind of look at it as a speech and language or a language activity. Pretend that Elsa isn't the ice queen. Pretend that she's maybe the sun queen or the heat queen, something that's hot. And how different would the story be if she set everything to blazing hot Texas summertime instead of super cold snowing all the time? Would Olaf still exist? If Olaf didn't exist, what would the character that would be in his spot, what would that be? Would it be a little sunball? Would it be a sweat puddle? You know, what would it be? And so kind of compare and contrast what you've got there. Switch the story around. Would their names be the same? Or could you change the names up to something else? Instead of Kristoff being a guy that sells ice, what could he sell in the heat? That kind of thing. Have some fun with it. Maybe the kids could even write their own story. That would be a really good thing to work on. Handwriting, sentence structure, grammar, all that English language arts stuff that they're lacking right now. They could actually write the story out and also illustrate it. So now you're getting in some art time as well. So I think I've given some pretty good things about using the movies Frozen 1, Frozen 2. Another thing, before I forget, you could also do some math stuff. I guess it could fit in with math, but temperature. And I guess that's also, it could also fit in kind of with science as well. Talk about what temperature things boil. Talk about what temperature things freeze. All that kind of good stuff. These are all different things that you can touch on with your kiddos, and it's all based off of the movie Frozen, so it makes it super easy. And maybe you tell them at the beginning of the day or the beginning of the week, hey, our movie for the week is Frozen. we're going to do XYZ throughout the day or XYZ throughout the week. You work hard, and at the end of the week on Friday, we're going to watch this movie. Or tonight at dinner, we're going to watch, or after dinner, we're going to watch this movie and have some family time. The point of all of these videos that I've been doing this week is to get away from thinking that you have to sit down and do worksheets with your kiddos in order to get all of these things in. That's not the case. I actually had a talk with one of my homeschool families today, and we were talking about the idea of parents having to basically homeschool their kids right now, and we talked about the idea of having to unschool ourselves on what school is supposed to look like. It can look like whatever you want, because the kids are going to soak in all of that stuff that you're doing, and they're going to remember it. They're going to remember that water freezes at 32 degrees when they are picking away at digging out their toys that they want to play with. Or, hey, I remember that ice forms at this because we watched the movie Frozen and we talked about it, you know, that kind of stuff. And when you're sitting and watching these movies, you don't have to just sit and watch it. Talk about the story. If the child hasn't seen it before, go, what do you think's going to happen next? When you finish watching the movie, talk about what your favorite part was. Maybe get out some construction paper and let them draw or write about what their favorite part of the movie was. Don't just end it with, oh, there's our movie. Yay! Use that. It's the same thing as a book. It's just an hour and a half to 2 hours long. And you happen to possibly be eating popcorn or cookies while you're watching it. So those are some things that you can do. Let's run through that list really quick. Your snack idea is ice cream, popsicles, snowflake cookies that you make, or you can make your own ice cream. Gross motor, play the song Let It Go forever loud and let them dance and run and play and all that kind of good stuff while they're singing it. If you have kiddos that are working on articulation with their speech therapist, that is also a great time to work on carryover and making sure that they're using their good speech sounds during that song as well. So there you go. Some of the other little things that you can do that don't require a whole lot is, remember, freeze some of their small toys in ice and let them dig them out. You could also make snow. Remember, you can get on Pinterest. Pinterest is your friend at this point in time, so get on there, use your ideas. You could also, I'm forgetting some of them, I know, so I hope you've watched this all the way through, because I know I'm forgetting some of them now. You can also, remember, talk about temperature. What temperature does it water freeze? What point does it boil? All that kind of good stuff. If it's room temperature, leave some water out. Let the kiddos use a thermometer and see what temperature, see what degree room temperature water is. Have some fun with it that way. Then you can also go, okay, if we're at boiling, how many degrees do we need to take off in order to get to room temperature? Or how many degrees do we need to take off to get to freezing? So there's some more math stuff in there for you. How about that? Then you can also use the science part of it, talking about a thermometer and all that kind of good stuff, because that kind of also is fitting in with our math stuff that we've used. You could compare and contrast and pretend that Elsa is not the ice queen, she's a heat queen, and how would the story change? Then allow the kids to either write their own story, draw pictures, however you want to do it. Maybe even act it out. That might be a fun thing to do. They make their own little costumes and they act out the new and improved, not frozen. You might call it boiling. You might call it Texas summer. I don't know. Who knows? Have fun with it that way. Then when you watch the movie, talk about the movie as you're going through it. You know, what do you think is going to happen next? Let them talk about their favorite part at the end, that kind of stuff. It's a great time. Like I said, it's a great time to just be with your family. Don't think of traditional school as sit down and work, do worksheets. Have some fun with it. That's what this is for. So I hope you guys all enjoyed that one. I tried to make it a little bit more organized. I don't really go off of any of these notes, any notes on these videos. So you're getting the, as it pops into my head or as it's kind of in here, it's coming out. So you're welcome. And I hope you guys all have a wonderful evening. And I will see you guys all again on YouTube tomorrow. Bye.